Thank you. Let's praise the Lord in this place.
Reading in your bulletin, in your program. Amen. A call to worship. Bless the Lord who forgives our sins.
His mercy endures forever.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desire known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
We will now be calling for our invocation, Pastor Francieta Dennis.
Amen.
Come on, let's give her a hand. Let's give her a hand.
Come on and stand to your feet for prayer. Amen. And if all minds are clear, Father, in the magnificent name of Jesus, we come before you today with a spirit of humility. We come to give you the honor, the glory, and all of the praise. Oh God, we ask you right now to search each and every one of us in this household of worship. If there be any spots, any wrinkles, any blemishes, we ask that they all be removed in the magnificent name of Jesus. And then, Lord, we ask that you forgive us the sins of omission and commission. And for this, we will be grateful. What greater way to give you praise, God, than to close out this holy convocation for this consecration service? Oh, God, we ask that you have your decrease, Lord. You increase. Jesus. Now just before I take my seat, open your mouth, throw your head back, and when I count to three, I want you to scream Jesus. We set the atmosphere up in here.
Jesus.
God to praise. Come on, let's bless God for Alpha and Omega. The beginning and the end. How many know that Jesus will keep you? Somebody say, I know he'll keep me. So you don't know the story behind the glory. Oh, come on, give God some praise. But one thing, I know he'll keep me. The College of Bishops and Apostles, amen, amen, all of the, amen, just the body of Christ and the pastors and everyone, amen, we do give honor but to Bishop Elect. Somebody ought to shout hallelujah. Because I remember the day when he walked in here. And his wife was so persistent about him coming. Shout glory. But how many of you know he came in the house and didn't leave the same? There's a song that I went to a meeting one night. To celebrate and elevation, thank God for everyone. Amen. These wonderful apostles, I bless God and bishops because I just made a phone call. You got to live so you can just make a phone call. We got to learn to come together. You know, I'm gonna say this and I'm getting into my word because. Y'all don't like to talk about this. See, y'all scared they're going to take y'all 501. And... Hallelujah. But those people, they coming together to get what they want. Can I be real? The lesbians that hooked up, the black ones, the white ones. Oh, y'all looking at me funny. Don't talk about lesbians in church no more because... Oh, I'm sorry, y'all. Come on, bless God. The homosexuals that came together.
Amen.
They're not looking at color. They just want results.
Amen.
And imagine if all caught people really came together. Y'all ain't singing that. And we just put down our differences because I have to understand going to God. Amen. Even the Bible said that I will give you pastors after my own heart. And amen. I may preach one way and you may preach another way and I may teach another way. But if we're lifting up Jesus, the Bible said if I be lifted up, I'll draw. How many of you need God to draw some folks in? I don't know about y'all, but I got a sister that need to come in. Somebody shout glory. I got a son that's confused, amen, my baby son, that needs to come in. So I need somebody to help me lift Jesus. I say, if you help me lift Jesus, if you help me lift Jesus, I don't have time to be lifting up men. I don't have time to be Jesus. If we lift up Jesus, a change is gonna come. Somebody shout glory. So I ain't gonna be long. I'll give you a sermon that we get done. Shout glory. We've been in church since Wednesday. Amen. I've been in church all month. Come on, bless God. The Lord is good. Go with me to Romans 8, and then we're gonna go over to Book of Timothy. Amen. Romans 8:38.
All right.
Amen. Amen. I can't say what I want to say because it would take me all night. Because I love this man of God. I love his wife. And the love is genuine. Amen. And it's real. And I'm just happy to be a part of his destiny.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I praise God. Romans 8:38 says, "For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature," somebody say any,
any.
Other creature, "shall be able to separate us from the love of God,
amen,
which is in Christ Jesus, yes, our Lord." Go with me over, I love this, to Timothy. I'm going to keep it plain and simple. Amen.
Amen.
Timothy chapter 4. That's what happened. We tried to get so deep and we left, amen, talking about holiness. And we started naming it and claiming it. And everything started coming up in the church. And preachers started falling. Come on, talk to me. And amen, the divorce court is the highest among, amen, Christians. Y'all ain't saying that. I do research. Can we keep it real? Come on, y'all. Flow with me. Can we just be real for a few minutes? But I look at this. Amen. Amen. 1 Timothy. I think I want 2 Timothy. 2 Timothy, that's what I want. 2 Timothy. Amen. The 4th chapter. "I charge thee before God and the Lord Jesus Christ." See, what we have to understand is that we all have a charge to keep. And a God to glorify.
Amen, amen.
"I charge thee therefore before God." So many times we thinking about, amen, we're concerned about answering to man.
Amen.
But our first answer should be to God.
Amen.
Because see, if we answer to God and we do it right, we won't have a problem with being obedient to man. And those that have the authority over us.
Amen.
He said, "I charge thee before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall judge the quick and the dead, and his appearing and his kingdom." In other words, God gonna have the last say so.
Amen.
But because I know God gonna have the last say so, I have a charge to keep.
Amen.
And if I had to give you something to just think about today, Bishop, you have a charge to keep. Somebody shout glory. You have a charge with folks that want to act right. You have a charge, amen, and I'm going to be real, when the wife don't want to act right. You even have a charge when you don't want to act right. Can I be real with you? Somebody shout glory. Well, preacher, what is my charge? I got to preach the word. Somebody shout glory. Y'all come on. I love the dance. I love the way Apple and Omega move. But I Jesus where? Show glory. He had the word. The word woke him up. The word say, my father is rich in all of the land. The word. They don't have to stay here. Give them the word. Give them the word. Somebody shout glory. You got a son out there. Elevated. I'm like Apostle Stafford. shocked. But let me tell you something about me. I had someone telling me one time. I was so mad. Stay with me, Pastor, Minister Veronica. I need you here. I was so mad. I was so church hurt. I was so disgusted with a lot of stuff I had held in me. Shout glory. Y'all looking at me great. Some of y'all got held in you. Shout glory. I'm just keeping it real. Preaching the gospel with held in me. Shout glory. I was mad and I was angry. And they say, you've been called to an apostle. I say, well, I ain't going up there until I get all this stuff out of me. Somebody shout glory. See, amen, we got to live what we preaching about. I may preach good, but on the inside you'll know when you're right. See, when you got the word in you, you can't live any kind of way. You can't do any kind of thing. Somebody shout glory. As pretty as I am, I won't be a honey. And I can't have no honey. I got to wait on Jesus. Somebody shout glory. We need to have the power. We need to do like them old mothers used to do. mercy. Pastor Bentley came to be an alcoholic. Am I right? He's been alcoholic. But the word was being preached. He didn't have to go to AAA. He went to Jesus. See, the word has power. I say the word has power. We too concerned about, amen, titles and positions and the church bank account. Clean them up and give them the word. Some of the best missionaries used to be whores, but they heard the word. Some so sick of church religious folks. Somebody shout glory. Send me some women with some tattoos that's ready for the word. That's ready to wipe their face like Mary Magdalene. Somebody shout glory. You're so missing. Looking at the wrong thing. Give them the word. The word will change their lives. Somebody shout glory. I got some extra ripples up in here. But the word brought them out the club. Somebody shout glory. I'll draw me. He says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things, not some things, all these things. The psalmist said, thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee. We're living in perilous times, y'all. Preacher, we're living in perilous times. Let me share something. I'm going to run through. The Lord was praying one day, and the Lord told me, he said, every time when those laws are passed, a married person gets a divorce. See, what y'all don't understand, we're wrestling not against flesh and blood, but spiritual wickedness in high places that nobody want to deal with. We want to feel good, you know. Prophesy to me and give me a word. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, this right, and all these things will be added unto you. Seek God. Amen. And his word. There's nothing like it. My husband been dead for 5 years. And God said, I've never seen the righteous forsaken. I ain't saying I've been on that purpose, but the word. The word. The word brought the prodigal son back. We need a revolution, y'all, of the Holy Ghost. As I go to my seat, Bishop, keep preaching the word. I hear you preach all the time. I won't get a big breakdown in case I ask God, Lord, I ain't got time for all that. But we live in a time now where people have itching ears. The Bible says they should turn away their ears from the truth and shall be turned into fables. But watch thou in all things endure afflictions. We got to be ready as leaders to endure some things. Do the work of an evangelist. Make full proof of thy ministry. Amen. God's raising you up as a bishop. Amen. Calling. God's going to send churches to you. Amen. Amen. But keep preaching the word. Amen. If they try to slide your money and want to pay you, amen, to not, oh, the devil is a liar. Keep preaching the word. Amen. Because see, it was the word that brought you in. Amen. And every now and then God got to remind us, we got to kiss that same word. You know what happened? We got a little bit of revelation knowledge. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And we forgot the word. Yeah. Are y'all hearing me? Amen. But we need the word. Yeah. We need that word that's going to change. Yeah. I'm so sick of folks coming to church and going back the same way. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We need something that's going to change their mind. Yeah. And that's only the word. Everything you need is in the word. God. Amen. There comes a time in your life when you feel like you're all by yourself. Pastor them came and asked me one day, say, you been to the movies to see something? I said, I don't go to the movies because I don't have nobody to go with. Some things I don't like doing by myself. They felt sorry for me, came and took me to the movies. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sometimes it's a lonely walk. Amen. You won't get the invitations. But keep preaching the word.
Amen.
Keep doing what God said to. Amen. You'll see the results of preaching the word. Folks may not pat you on the back all the time, but you know what's important? When you stand before God, he says, servant, well done.
Amen.
Somebody ought to give him praise. I'm not no judge, and I'm so sick of folks talking about, you can't judge me. The Bible says the saints will judge the world.
Amen.
Oh yeah, I read my word. I'm glad somebody judged me one day and told me get it right. Shout glory. I'm glad it was my apostle. Amen, amen. Sister apostle. Amen. Great correction in my life because he loved me. Somebody ought to shout glory. When the men and women of God, see, that's the word.
Amen.
Amen. Sometimes, preacher, just keep preaching the word.
Amen.
Amen. They get mad at me sometimes. I'm going through something right now, but it's all right. I'll stand on the word. Because if he did it before, he'll do it again. So he said, I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging for bread.
Amen.
You know what? I ain't giving the devil no praise. I'm still a demon buster.
Amen.
You gotta know who you are. And sometimes you gotta put your hand.
I love you, Lord. And I leave my in my heart.
Made me cry. Pastor Davis, I got a surprise for you, man. young pastor and a deacon. Put your hands together and thank God for the word. Bishop elect Cleo Fred Bentley Jr. You are called to guard the faith, unity, and discipline of the church, to celebrate and provide for the administration of the sacraments, amen, of the new covenant, to ordain elders and deacons, and to join in ordaining bishops, and to be in all things a faithful pastor and wholesome example for the entire flock of Christ. With your fellow bishops, you will share in the leadership of the church throughout the world. Your heritage is the faith of patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and mortals, and those of every generation who have looked to God in hope. Your calvary is to endure the loneliness of the office, to never require approval, but exercising your duty to act in the best interest of Christ's church. Your joy will be to follow them who came, not to be served, but to serve, and who gave his life a ransom for many. Are you, Bishop-elect Cleo Fred Bentley Jr., persuaded that God has called you to the office of the bishop?
Yes, I am.
Amen. Right now, we'll have the inquiry by Apostle Stanford. Remain standing.
Bishop, will you accept this call in obedience to Christ?
Yes, I will.
Will you be faithful in prayer and in the study of the Holy Scripture, that you will continue to have the mind of Christ?
I will, Lord.
Will you boldly proclaim and interpret the gospel of Christ, enlighten the mind and stirring up the conscience of your people?
I will, with the Lord's help.
As a chief elder and pastor, will you ensure and support all baptized believers in their gifts and ministries? Nourish them from the riches of God's grace. Pray for them without ceasing, and celebrate with them the sacraments of our redemption.
Yes, I will.
Will you guard the faith, unity, and discipline of the church?
Yes, I will.
Will you share with your fellow bishops in the government of the whole church? Will you sustain your fellow presbyters and take counsel with them? Will you guide and strengthen the deputies and all others who minister in the church?
Yes, I will.
At this time, we want to call Apostle Mims in the consecration of the bishop. Following her, we will be having prayer and of the consecrators and the Dr. Mims and the College of Bishops.
Would the College of Bishops and Apostles join Dr. Mims?
full.
Hallelujah.
Because I know that your father, your spiritual father, and your natural father will be very proud of you today.
Amen.
And I know that I birthed you in the spirit, and I'm so proud when I hear you preach. I hear so much of me and you. So with this oil, along with the College of the Bishops, we're just going to anoint you. God is our good anointing.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Everybody to anoint him, and we're going to pray in the name of Jesus. As we pray, as all the college bishops come forward. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, we come to you. You are the Holy of Holies. And God, we thank you right now for this mighty man of God. God, that you're elevating on today for the office of the bishop. Father, he's made full proof of his ministry. He has been found faithful of the call, God. And Father, I pray over him right now. God, we anoint him in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you. He called my mother a second for a greater anointing. A greater anointing in his life, God. God, I ask that you would just consecrate it, God. Make it worthy of the call, God, in the name of Jesus. Cover him under your precious blood right now. Hide him, God. Hide him in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, keep his mind on you, God. Father, I thank you right now. God, I bind up anything that's not like you. I rebuke anything that will try to come up against the work that he has to do. Father, we take full authority in the name of Jesus. And God, we thank you right now. God, we thank you for the word that's in him, God. We thank you, God. We thank you, God, for the assignment that's on his life, God. We thank you, Lord, for the churches, God, that he will establish. We thank you, God, for the people that have been assigned to him, God, in the name of Jesus. But most of all, God, we thank you, God, for his humility, God. We thank you, God. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus. God, I thank you right now. Oh, God, I pray the blessings of Abraham over his life, God. In the name of Jesus. Oh, God. In the name of Jesus. And God, we thank you right now. And God, it is so. We thank you. We thank you. God, it is finished. We thank you, Lord. And we give you praise. We give you glory. We thank you for a greater glory in this life, God. A greater glory. A greater glory. Father, we thank you for this bishop. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Come on, bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Since the days of Moses,
in the book of Leviticus, where God anointed his people to accept the new role, where there was always an investiture, a consecration, an ordination, which symbolized the taking on of a new authority.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
A new sphere of authority.
Yes.
A new realm of dimension.
Yes. Hallelujah.
And as it was with the people of those days, so it is today in the Lord's church. These vestments represent the holy garments of the priesthood and the seal of the bishop. The cassock, which bishop-elect is already adorned with, is a sign of a servant's heart. The cassock is a close-fitting garment reaching the floor and may be worn by or their clergy as a symbol of servitude, a servant. The bishop continues to wear the cassock as a part of his garb, symbolizing what Jesus instructed in Matthew 23:11. Those who would be chief among us must be a servant. The cassock is the closest garment to the bishop's hide, and the heart of the bishopship is servant leadership. Next is the cincture by Bishop David Black. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, Father. As a symbol of humility. The cincture is the material formed in a Cumberland style fashion with a cassock. It is girded around the waist as a sign of a humble servant to all mankind. The scripture tells us that we must be girded with truth. And such truth is that the minister is first and foremost a humble servant. The cincture obtains the symmetry from the towel which our Lord girded himself. Oh my God. As he humbled himself to wash the disciples' feet. The cincture. The next garment is the brochette. Apostle Austin Bishop Black. The brochette is worn as a symbol of the priesthood. The white brochette is a symbol of Aaron's white linen ephod, which was worn by bishops and apostles, and is a symbol of the warrior's robe as a celebrant of the sacraments and the chief worship leader among God's people. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Glory to God.
Glory.
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 Garment is the shamir, Apostle Curry. The shamir is worn as a symbol of the mantle of the prophet. The shamir is a sleeveless garment, usually and sometimes in black, purple, or red. It is
is an upper robe of the bishop and the apostle and is only worn by the bishop and the apostle, which symbolizes one of the chief proclaimers and the defenders of the faith.
Hallelujah.
In the apostolic kingdom. And the question is, can you wear the coat? Have you paid the cost to wear the coat? Oh my God. Oh my God. The next garment is the tippet. Apostle Stanford, the black tippet is worn as a symbol of the preacher. The tippet is a skillful wide cut of material placed over the shamir. The tippet is symbolized as one called to the office, denoting one who is yoked. The tippet, being the fifth part of the priestly garment, represents grace. At this time, I'm going to ask the bishops to yoke the bishop. Grab both ends of the tippet. Prophesy over him. Thank you, Father. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Can you stand under the weight? Oh, my God, my God, my God. Apostle, would you all yoke? Thank you, God. The ring is worn on the right hand as a life committed and dedicated to Christ and the church. Would you place it on his right? The ring is a token of covenant between the bishop and God.
Hallelujah.
Somebody tell God, thank you. Wait a minute, Father. Wait a minute. Come on back. Come on back. That hand that you just adored, would you hold it? The acceptance of the ring is based upon the scripture concerning the prodigal son, and it demonstrates the favor of God upon the life of the bishop that is wearing it. The ring is the primary symbol of the office of the bishop. But we are not finished yet.
Thank you,
wife. You can stand to his side.
That's your bishop.
Amen.
That is your bishop.
Amen.
Next we have the mitre. Bishop Bernard. The mitre is a tall folding cap consisting of two separate parts, the front and the back. Rising to the peak and sewn together at the sides, two short lappets always hung down from the back. It is worn by the bishop and the apostle during the consecration. Affirmation. You have been adorned.
Yes, yes, yes.
Apostle. Chief Consecrator, Barbara Mint, Apostle. Is Sister Pelosi back? My God.
Hallelujah.
Remnant Kingdom Covenant Ministries International, Jacksonville, Florida, Fellowship of Churches, Incorporated. Certificate of Bishop Consecration. Be it known by the tenor of these presents that we, the Most Reverend Dr. Barbara D. Mims, PhD, by Divine Providence, Chief Apostle, and presiding prelate of the Remnant Kingdom Covenant Ministries International Fellowship of Churches, conferring holy orders of the protection of Almighty God in Jacksonville, Florida, on this ninth day of November in the year of our Lord 2014, did then and there, amen, and in accordance with the form prescribed in the Book of Common Prayer, ordain and consecrate as a bishop of the one holy, universal, and apostolic church of our dearly beloved brother, Cleo Fred Bentley Jr., of whose godly, sober, and honest life and conduct, competent learning, knowledge of the Holy Scripture, and soundness in the faith, we are well assured. He also having publicly and in our presence declared that he believes in the Holy Scriptures of both Old and New Testaments, being known to all who witness in the presence of the church, solemnly and publicly, we set ordained and consecrated anointing with oil and imposition of our hands, in testimony whereof we are to affix our apostolic signature, Jacksonville, Florida, on the date of the year in here written, the Most Reverend Dr. Barbara Mills, Chief Apostle and Presiding Prelate at the Remnant Kingdom Covenant Ministries. We present, amen, Bishop Cleo Fred Bentley Jr. Stand to your feet and give God praise. Got caught up, forgot one more. Amen. Amen. The word. Give you a pocket. The word. Amen. Well, I know it's in your heart. This is all you need. It's God's word. And a prayer life. Amen. Trials are gonna come. Amen. And like they say, this is a lonely walk sometimes. But thy word have I hid in my heart that I will not sin against God. To Bishop Fred C. Bentley. Amen. I already consecrated him. I present to you the Holy Bible. Amen. The Word of God. Preach the Word. The instant in season and out of season. Amen. Stand on the Word. Amen. It's not on paper. But to Lady Bentley. I love you so much. And these roses represent you. Because you are a rose to this man. Stand with him. Stand by his side. Amen. And now you need to lay on your face now more than ever. Amen. Because he has a greater assignment on his life. But there's power in a praying wife. Somebody shout glory. Sometimes you don't have to open your mouth, just pray. Amen. Around the kingdom. Come on, clap your hands and give God praise. You want to put a chair here? And then we're going to take up an offering and we're going to have them do the greetings. Amen. I want this chair turned around now. I need another chair. I want the wife to sit. Yes. Yeah, two chairs real clear. Amen. Okay. Amen. All right. Follow me as I follow Christ. Amen.
Daddy.
Y'all have a seat, please. I need a bucket right here. Right in front of him. Amen. Y'all say you love him, right? I say y'all say you love him, right?
Amen.
Amen. So I need, if you can follow with me. Amen. I have a $100 bill. I'm putting it at their feet.